Hello dear children, good morning. Moving towards our geography part, from today we will talk about our lesson number 13, that is India, location, geographical structure and physiography. Okay, so we all know that what is the shape of earth. Okay, you can see that what is the shape of earth, which is shown here, which is not basically round. So you could see some horizontal and vertical lines over there. So these horizontal and vertical lines are called latitudes and longitudes. And these latitudes and longitudes helps you to find the location of a place. Okay, so you can see that here in this map, which is already given in your textbook also. You will find that some degrees are mentioned here, and these degrees help you to find the location of the different places of the world. Okay. So we have a very unique position in the world. It is the largest democracy. Kindly note, my dear children, that India is the largest democracy of the world. It is the multicultural nation and it is the oldest in the world. It doesn't have any barriers of religion, races, or the people, but we have accepted everybody wholeheartedly. Okay, there is no impartiality towards the religion or people or any races, and is this a peculiar characteristics of India that makes India unique, different from the rest of the world. And that is why it has called to be the cultural confluence. Moving ahead, before I will bring to your notice that what the distinct characteristics which India has and which is not found into the rest of the world. See, you find any country of the world today, the country of the world are recognized by its religion. Like when we say Pakistan, we all know it's a Muslim country. When we say Bangladesh, we know it's a Muslim country. When we say Sri Lanka, we know that Buddhism is prevailed that. When we talk about any Gulf country, again Gulf country is identified with its religion. You see any European countries, all the European countries has Christianity. But my dear children, when we talk about India, India is the only country in the world where you can find all the religions of the world. Okay, there is no such country in the world where you can have the varieties of religion and different things. And my dear children, believe me, it is your religion that decides your culture. It is your religion that decides your festivals. It is your religion that decides your language. It is your religion that decides your food style, dressing style, etc. But when you see India like a country, it has Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Punjabis, Christians, Parsis and whatnot. Okay, and these all people, they have different culture according to their religion. And so that it is said that India is a secular country. We will talk about this term going ahead. When we talk secular, that means it is a country where there is no barriers of any religion and people free to follow the religion of his or her wish. So that's called secular country. So since this all the varieties in form of religion, in form of culture, in form of languages, in form of food style, in form of dressing style,
found in India. So India has a distinct quality of continent, and so that India can be called subcontinent country, because it has all the qualities which are found into any continent. Okay, my dear children, we had so many natural and man-induced diverse disasters, but still we were able to have a continuous progress. The geographical location of India has played a very important role as far as its development and the progress of its culture is concerned. So when we look at the location of India, it lies on the northern hemisphere, which extends to the southern part of Asia continent. That means one thing is very clear, that India lies into continent name Asia. Its location is 8.4 degrees to 37.6 degree north latitude to 68.7 degree to 97.25 degree east longitude. So that is the location of India. The Tropic of Cancer, that is, passes from the center of India, which is at the 23.5 north latitude, that divides India into two parts, two halves, which is called to be Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere. Okay, so this cracking line, if we can see that, you will notice that it passes from the center of India, and as a result of that, it parts, divides India into two parts. Okay, so those are called to be the northern part and southern part. The Great Plains and the Himalayan mountain systems are located in this part, whereas the south of the Tropic of Cancer has a triangle shape, which is also known as peninsula. It is towards its south. This is because basically of peninsular plateau, as I said. It includes the eastern coast plain and the narrow western coast plain. This will be better learned when you look at this map. Okay, see this. The Tropic of Cancer, if we can see from this particular Indian map, that this cracking line is passing from the center of India and it's divided India into two parts. So the upper part, which is called to be Northern Hemisphere, and the below part, which is called to be Southern Hemisphere. It is also known as a peninsula plateau. Peninsula plateau because you can see that it is in a triangle shape, and which is covered with the water body from all the three sides. And this is why it is said that India had a very important location, because in earlier time, the only means of transport was waterways for the means of international transport. And that was the reason that we had so many aliens, that they came to India and they settled here. Okay, so see here it is mentioned, from the distinct point, like as it is mentioned here, the distinct points from Ladakh to Kanyakumari, it is 3214 kilometers, and from Gujarat to Andhra Pradesh, it is 2933 kilometers. Here it is written 3214. That means the starting point is Ladakh, from the tip of India to the bottom of India, Kanyakumari, it is 3214. And here, which is starts from, you can see Gujarat, and which is goes to Arunachal Pradesh, this is 2933 kilometers. This is basically the area of India. It is in kilometers. Okay, so as a result of that, you can find the difference into the timings. We have a difference of the timings of 2 hours from one distinct place to another distinct place. In short, if I make you understand, when there is a morning in Arunachal Pradesh, there is a still night in Gujarat. So we have a difference of this 2 hours, and to mug up this difference, we have decided Indian Standard Time, IST, which is passing from 5 different states, and we have taken up Allahabad. That means since the Allahabad, it is into the center of India, So what time is there in Allahabad, the same time is to be followed into the thorough part of India. Clear? Now, when you look at the total area of India, the total area of India is 32.8 lakh square kilometer. India ranks 7th in the world into area. But before India, there are 6 more countries. This can be asked in 1 mark question. This can be asked into the filling the blank. So kindly note this, that the leading country in the world in area are Russia, Canada, USA, China, Brazil, and Australia. Okay? The land area of India that mostly lies into the southern part of Asia. In the northern lofty mountain ranges are spread over the hundreds of the kilometer from west to east direction that you can study from the map. That is why the commuting with Tibet and China is possible only through this location with the high altitude. Okay? Bay of Bengal lies in the east, Arabian Sea to the west and Indian Ocean to the south. To the peninsular India. Peninsular India, again I tell you, what do we call the peninsular? It is a triangle shape and with the cover with the water body. The sea is utilized as a waterway. As I said that in earlier time, we might have a question why that so many people like Portuguese, like Dutch, like people from Denmark, people from England, people from France, why did they visit our nation? Why did they come to India? The biggest reason behind that was our location. Because India's location was meant in a such a way that it is surrounded with the water bodies from 3 sides. In an earlier time, the only means of transport for international was waterways. Okay? So the sea is utilized as a waterways. Even though the land routes are obstructed by surrounding mountains. So India has accepted these cultural elements arrived from outside and they become the part of India. Clear? So these are, you can see, we have some sort of the cracking lines into the map and we have some straight lines. Here it is mentioned that those straight lines are meant for the air routes and the cracking lines are meant for the sea route. So we have hold a very strategic location, as I said, because it is surrounded with the water body from 3 sides. Ocean have contributed immensely, bluntly, into the development of our good relation with different countries of the world. It had a trade relation with East Africa, West Asia, South Africa, and Southeast Asia since ancient time. India has developed cultural and trade relations with the different countries of the world. No country in the Indian Ocean have long maritime boundary. Now understand this maritime boundary, it is a water boundary, sea boundary, okay, as India has. So here you can see that what sea boundary we have. It is the largest in the world and so that it has been named after India, that is Indian Ocean, correct? Now, location of India across international waterways is very important, and that was with the opening of the Suez Canal, which was locked and blocked by Europe, which was opened in 1869. As a result of that, the traveling between India and European countries was reduced almost by 7,000 kilometers. So it got the connectivity with East and Southeast Asia, Australia to Africa, and Europe passed through the Indian Ocean. So the Circum-African waterways and the Suez Canal waterways pass by India, Canada and USA can be reached through the same waterways via Strait of Malacca and the Pacific Ocean. So opening of the Suez Canal proved to be the boon for the rest of the world, because for the European countries it became easy to reach to India, because by opening of the Suez Canal almost the traveling distance of 7,000 kilometers was reduced. Okay, so we have contacts with many different countries of the world. Our goods ideas and thoughts has already been transferred and exchanged since ancient time. At the same time, also Upanishad, Ramayana, Panchatantra and therapeutic methods of India is also accepted by the rest of the world. Indian numerical figures and decimal system is also accepted by the world. It has a very important location into the South Asia. We have 28 states, one national capital and 7 union territories. I hope you know what is the capital of India. Okay. So one state which came into the existence in 2014, here it is mentioned, filling the blanks, it just can be asked that it was Telangana, which was separated from its mother state called Andhra Pradesh on the 2nd of June 2014. Okay, moving ahead to our neighboring countries. See that one map you can see, and in this map our different neighboring countries are shown. Like our neighboring countries are Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Bhutan, Myanmar, Nepal, etc. Okay. So these are the different countries that are sharing the land border with us, except the Sri Lanka, because with the Sri Lanka we share 32 kilometers of the sea border. Okay. So in the south, Sri Lanka and Maldives are our maritime neighbor. Now here it is, maritime word again has come, so I bring to your notice, my dear children, what is this maritime? It is the water border, the ocean border. India and Sri Lanka are separated by Palk Strait, another is Gulf of Mannar. We have islands like Lakshadweep, Andaman and Nicobar, but these Lakshadweep islands are located into the Arabian Sea, while Andaman and Nicobar islands are located into the Bay of Bengal. We had one distinct point called Indira Point, which was located at the southernmost tip of India. Okay, but it was submerged in 2004 due to tsunami. With these, few more islands which are located in Andaman and Nicobar were also submerged. So my dear children, this is what we have, some information about your lesson number 13 about the location, geographical structure and physiography of India. I am sure their concept must be very much clear as far as your location is concerned, your geological structure is concerned and physiography is concerned. Okay, as a part of your assignment, my dear children, the map which is shown here with the states of India and with its neighboring country, okay, please have one outline map of India. I would request you people to buy almost 15 to 20 outline maps of India, because every now and then whatever the maps which will be there in your textbook, that is to be copied and that is to be pasted in your fair. So this is map on 13.4 India and adjacent countries. So your assignment will be to follow the same outline map of India and write the states of India as well as the neighboring countries which are found in India. Okay, and kindly fare the same map in your fare while you write the question answers of the same. We will be continue with the remaining portions tomorrow. Till then, my dear children, take care. Bye bye.